Hi, welcome to NCERT Class 11 Fine Arts Series. This is a paid course, but we'll be providing it for free until the response is very good. And this is Fine Arts. First of all, Arts has a main part in mains rather than prelims. Prelims also you can expect few questions, but for mains for sure you'll be having some questions on this part. It is there in GS paper 1, and so you have to be ready with the preparation of this. And we are going to see NCERT class 11 part 1, the chapter 1, prehistoric paintings. For studying prehistoric paintings, first let us see what is a historic period and what all the elements involved in it. The prehistory is something for which we don't have any record of what happened during that period. We don't have any inscriptions or any manuscripts or any sorts of records. For medieval we have manuscripts, and for modern India we have archives of British India as well. For prehistory, that is ancient history, prehistory, we don't have something like that. And so we just assume with the things we get from the excavation, like old tools, pottery, habitats, from these we just assume what would have happened for these people. And the prehistoric period is also known as old stone age or the Paleolithic age. And during this period, when the basic needs of food, water, clothing and shelter were fulfilled, the people felt they need to express themselves, and they started various art forms. The first art form was drawing and painting, for which they used their cave walls as their canvas. Prehistoric period was divided into Lower Paleolithic and Upper Paleolithic. We don't find any art forms in the Lower Paleolithic period. And in the Upper Paleolithic period, the walls of many caves of this time found around the world was full of finely carved finely painted pictures of animals which were supposed to be hunted by the people who lived during those times. And the subjects was mainly human figures and human activities, and some of the animal symbols were also found during that time. You can refer to the above picture given for some of the example how it might have been looked. First discovery of rock paintings was done by Archibald Carrelly in 1867 to 68. This was 12 years before even Altamira discovery. Burn, Anderson and Mitra Ghosh were the early archaeologists who discovered a large number of sites in India. The remnants of rock paintings are also found on the walls of Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Bihar, where we can find large number of caves. And on these caves we find the rock paintings. So the remnants is the remains of the rock paintings, few of the rock paintings. For some rock paintings we get the full thing, some we have remains of here and there. And we have the famous caves all over here. In the rock shelter on the bank of real Suyal or Lakudiyar is a place in Uttar Pradesh, and this is these bare historic prehistoric paintings. And this Lakudiyar means literally 1 lakh caves. The paintings found here is divided into 3 categories, that is animal, man, animal and geometric patterns. And it is painted in black, white and red ochre. And humans are represented in stick-like forms. You can see here, there is the humans are represented only in the stick-like forms. There is no proper figure, exact figure is not replicated. And a long-snouted animal, for example, a fox, a multiple-legged lizard, which we don't find nowadays. But these are all the main animal motifs we can see in these paintings. And on the geometric patterns, they have wavy lines, rectangle-filled geometric designs, and group of dots. The hand-linked dancing is a interesting picture. This is what is that. This has been found in Lakudiyar in Uttarakhand, and it is replicated in many places also, wherever we will find the prehistoric paintings. And there is also superimposition of paintings. For example, they paint a layer of painting, and then over these there is another layer of painting, and over that a last group of painting is there. Like first it is painted in black, and then over red, and then last as white, so that it is visible in that way. You can also see this in this picture, this white is painted in the background and the top of it red is painted. Similar way, it is being painted in many places. Kashmir has two slabs of with engravings, and Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh, the granite rocks provided suitable canvases. So this granite rocks has been a very good canvas for the Neolithic man's imaginations. So they, you can find lots of prehistoric paintings in that on the basis of Neolithic. And Kupgalu, Pikli Hal and Tekal Kota are the famous of these in found in Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. There are three types of paintings. Paintings found in white, painting found in red over a white background. Paintings in red ochre. The prehistoric paintings in India. The subjects depicted are majorly of animals, and animals are bulls, elephants, sambar, gazelles, sheep, goats, and horses. And the humans were stylized. They were designed with masks or something like that. And the richest paintings were reported in the Vindhya ranges of Madhya Pradesh and Kaimuran extensions into the Uttar Pradesh. These were full of forest, and these provided as the natural habitats for the prehistoric man. And so we can find a lot of paintings over there. They had wild plants, animals, fruits, and so these were also full of Paleolithic and Mesolithic remains. In India, the prehistoric painting is found majorly in Ajanta Caves, Ellora Caves and Elephanta Caves and Bimbetkar Caves, which are also listed in the UNESCO's World Heritage Site. Ajanta and Ellora was listed during 1983, and later Elephanta and Bimbetka. Elephanta was added in 1987 and Bimbetka was added in 2003 in the world's UNESCO World Heritage Site. Do also check out the other World Heritage Sites of India, important one for prelims basis. And please do subscribe and watch the other playlist of Vaish IAS channel. We are providing this for free, and if the response is really good, we'll be continuing it, or else this will be changed into the paid courses. Do WhatsApp to this number for the details of the UPSC test series. Thank you.